What you're about to see is an episode of Comedy After Dark. This was a TV show that aired in Connecticut, 1992 to 1994, and starred high school friends. There was no high definition then. We shot the show on VHS tape. The old tapes broke down over time, leaving some episodes with poor video quality.
Because it's a very hot day out there. It's like 85. It's a beautiful day, though. And it's, you know, it's the end of the summer. But I was talking to George Bush earlier, and he agreed to do an interview. Lawrence Degley's also here. He's somewhere out there. He's looking for Ronald Reagan, who got lost. But the two presidents will be here. And this will be a special weekend news, and I hope you all watch. I'll be out here with Lawrence, and John will be in the studio. So now, ladies and gentlemen, back to John, and we'll begin the show. Ready? Action!
Okay, now let's start the comedy hour. Let's roll the tape.
Jokes, because now we have a monologue again. Hey, it is hot out there. It's a nice day here on August, I don't know. But this is our 13th show. And, it goes pretty well. Okay, let me think of my comedy now. Let's see what I'm going to talk about. How certain expressions came to be. Now there's a few I would say, but, this is public television, so I can't swear. But, like expressions like,
Jack Sugar.
Yeah, you don't know Jack Sugar. Of course it means
sugar.
Of course it means Jack. But, I mean, where'd it come from? But You'll have to watch me on my live stand-up comedy things, you know, to hear it. You better show up. But, I can't remember what I was going to do now. Let me see.
Before I forget, Mike.
I can't remember any of my jokes. But, anyways, we have a big show, so I just want to get started. By the way, what do you think of the new theme? Now, I got some bad news today. GRP Records, who were in charge of our theme song, Flashpoint, by Tom Scott, told me we can't play it unless we pay them a certain amount. We have no budget here. No budget. Yes. So, we have to get a new song. So basically, we have a new theme, a new song.
Any suggestions that people might have?
Yeah. Oh, by the way, I'll talk to you at the desk about this. Why don't we just get started? We'll be back after this with a commercial for the Appletons. So we'll be back in a moment.
On your desk, or desk, where'd you put them?
There. Well, hello there. And I'm Buddy Appleton. That's right, the father of this large family. And well, you know, we're coming soon to the Comedy Hour. Son! How you doing, son?
Gee, Pop, how are you today?
Oh, I'm doing just fine. Are you looking forward to our new show on the Comedy Hour?
What new show, Pop?
Called The Appleton, starring our family.
That is new. Thank you, Lee.
That's right. You got to see... Please don't do that, son. You got to see our first show on the Comedy Hour a few times ago, where we all pretended to be an angry family. But now you get to see our perky little family as it happens. So watch the Comedy Hour live every week.
Dad.
Yes, son?
Can I go to Harvard?
Why, sure you can. Goodbye.
Bye.
Welcome to the Comedy Hour. What do you think, huh? The new set.
Yeah.
Huh? Look at that. New background and everything. Yeah. 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 Again. Oh, the curtain's gone. We have a big stage. We need lighting. But we have a few things to talk about today. Look at this. Get close up over here. Well, let me bring out Lawrence. Lawrence, come on out here. Our lovely announcer and sidekick, Lawrence.
Hi. How are you?
Just kidding. How you doing?
Okay, how are you guys?
Oh, pretty good. Oh, you know, this is your third show here.
Yep.
And, this is basically a new type of show. We got a new song, a new beginning.
Yeah,
a new set. And we've changed it. Now, today, we usually do the phone, but we have... being that this is the end of summer, this is basically our last week here of summer vacation, and we gotta go back to school. But we lost a few cast members, and I want to tell you, our 15th show coming up soon. We're gonna be filming it soon. Also, we'll be talking about the past, 6 months we've been doing this show. Now we lost Robert Liston. He never showed up. Even Lawrence, he's just started and he's been here more. He showed up like for 10 minutes and then was gone.
So I had to... complained about it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Have to do that next week.
Yeah, he always complained about it. But yeah, every time I say, look, I'm going to have to get rid of you, he always, no, please. So I fired him. And Aaron Fleming and James Glover, I don't know their situation.
Never here.
Yes, they never come. Now, James... I gotta give him credit because he did show up to a few shows. He came here one weekend, but most of the time he's not here.
Have I been here more than he
Yes.
Oh, wow.
Actually,
Yeah.
There's a few times we didn't get a chance to film him while he still came.
Yeah.
But I don't know. I think I'm not going to really get fire James. We'll have him as a special guest.
We'll use him. He's not really getting channel.
Yeah, he has to deal with 32. And by the way, James, how, when are you going to put us on the air?
Oh, we're waiting.
Yeah, I know. We're going to call them up a little later and settle this. But,
they're watching us now.
Yes. Now you guys are watching us, but we filmed the show 5 years ago, and it's just getting on TV
we're
now.
We're all 20 now.
Yeah. John lives in Oklahoma. I live in California. Arizona, actually.
Arizona.
Yeah. Lawrence is busting some people. He's a cop. Well, actually, he's on...
on welfare.
By the way,
Well, I got some good news for this show. If we do well, and I got some word from head offices, we're going to get a national network show.
Yeah!
And so you may be seeing us, you know, every day, 5 days a week, the real show. Lawrence will be coming with us.
From California.
Yes, from California. I made a big decision. No, seriously. Chris Pott won't be going, of course. Seriously, he won't go. He's going because he's got a lot of years left to school. But I will be going.
I'll go.
And John and Lawrence probably won't be. We'll get tutors and I'll have to go to school.
Yeah! And I got 1 year left, though.
Yeah, that's right. I've got two. This year and next. And then I'm out. I'm gone. Out of this East Coast. East Coast is not bad, but... I just care. By the way, Lawrence,
yes.
Get a close-up on this.
You're the camera guy and you're sitting down.
Oh, Jesus!
Because we have no
budget. No budget at all. We have, of course, as we said in the past,
no budget.
No. We have no budget, that's right. No budget! Now, get a close-up right on this. Come on up.
Yeah, Lawrence, look at this, huh?
Uh-huh. I'm a member of the Star Chat Club, the video club, that's right. Look at this, I am proud to say I'm a member. You suck, camera guy.
Wait,
Yeah, let's get a close-up on this. Dum, dum, dum. You know, life is a highway. I want to drive all night long.
By the way, I want to show you something here.
Look at the coal, just laid down.
What an action-packed show.
All right. Okay, now this here, radioactive mouse... Yeah, this is radioactive mouse crap. It's metal. Big mouse came and look what it did. Okay, well, before we go to some business, why don't we do our regular business? Things said and not said. This week's topic is the president. You know, the Republican convention that just happened. This is things the president would say, things he wouldn't say. Now, I have to rip this in half so Florence can read it, so if you could just hold on for a moment.
We need to know a bit of music to play.
Okay, ready? Things said, not said, the president. Something they'd say.
Something the president would say. Read by
the mic. You can get the microphone.
All right.
Duplex stereos.
More Jeopardy.
By the way, we do have new speakers, so we're very happy about that because Blackie Lowry, I wanna ride all night long. Yeah, I can hear the lady singing back there. What's going on?
Okay.
Check.
Okay. Are we ready?
All right, Mr. Redbeck. Okay. One said, not said. Something said, President.
Something the President would say. Read my lips.
Something he wouldn't say. Read my lips. That's something he wouldn't say.
Something the president would say. A kinder and gentler nation.
Something I wouldn't say. Eat me, America. Eat me!
Something the president would say. A thousand points of light.
Something I wouldn't say. I have 420 cockroaches in the Senate.
Something the president would say. Dan Quayle is my vice president.
Something I wouldn't say. Mike Tyson, Mike Gardner. That's something he wouldn't say. Well, it is fun. You know, I miss the laugh machine. I really miss it.
Yeah, same here. Okay. Something the president would say. Say hello.
I'm too sexy for my show. I'm too sexy for my show.
All right, okay.
Something the president would say?
Something the president would say. Say hello to my dog, Millie.
Something he wouldn't say. Something he wouldn't say. Say hello to my dinky, Sam. Say hello to my dinky, Sam. Little dinky.
Okay. Something the president would say. No new taxes.
Something he wouldn't say. Excuse me, but that wasn't supposed to be funny. Something he wouldn't say. Let's try that again. Something he would say.
Something the president would say. No new tax. No.
Yeah, no new taxes.
No new taxes.
Something he wouldn't say. No new quail. Something he'd say?
Something the president would say. I'm the president.
Something he would say. I'm the Marlboro King.
Something the president would say. Family values are important.
Something you would say, enlarged.
Let's try that again. Let's do that again.
We'll edit this out. Ready? Something you would say.
Something the president would say. Family values are important.
Something you would say, in-laws are not. Something he'd say.
Please
say it again for those people in the audience who. Okay. Something the president would say.
What was that?
No. Family values are important. Something you would say, in-laws are not.
Yeah.
Okay.
Why don't we just end it here? That's it. I'm leaving the building. I quit. Okay. Something you'd say.
Something the president would say. Saddam Hussein is a loser.
Something you would say. Berlin Quail's my love, guys. And finally,
something the president would say. Wouldn't be prudent.
Something he wouldn't say. Finally, the last thing said, not said. And by the way, this is the last thing said, not said forever. This is it. Yeah. This is the final thing said. You'll never hear it again. Because I got a new feature coming on called Good Things and Bad Things. It's much more funnier and
funner.
I guess I need to go back. No, I don't.
Yeah, right.
Yeah. But actually,
I already have a headache. I've been doing this for so long.
Now, this is it, ladies and gentlemen. The final, last thing said, not said list you will never see here again unless we find something really damn funny. Ladies and gentlemen, here it is. Something the president would say?
It wouldn't be prudent.
Something he wouldn't say? Shut that damn noise in the back. Okay, now something he wouldn't say? Kill me, baby. Kill me, baby. And that was it!
Yeah!
It's over! Yeah. There will never be another thing said, not said here again after Comedy Hour. It's over!
Yeah.
But, Nick, just kidding. No. Oh, pussy cat.
All right, we're back. Come on.
Okay, now, did I mention this? I'm the Star Trek Club. Okay. Let's bring out John. You could sit here. John, why don't you come here and take a seat by our sidekick? Yeah. Okay, my guy, let's go. Come on. Now, gentlemen, we've got some news. The theme song that we've been using now, I just got a phone call today. They said I can't use it unless we have a budget. And we have no budget.
We have no budget.
So we can't pay for it. So our original theme song, I liked it, but it's gone now. Basically, we're going to use this dinky little song on our keyboard temporarily.
Hopefully temporarily.
Yeah. Because we have some news.
We have serious malfunctionings going on in the building. Because we have
no budget.
Zero budget.
But
I want to know, what's the name of this GMC Records?
GRP.
GRP.
Yeah.
I never heard of these people. One, everybody's fighting over it. They should be lucky that we're giving them publicity.
That's true. And I don't get paid. Can you control the camera here? What is this? You're part of the show. Let's go. Our camera guy is not going to be here much longer.
You would get publicity if you came here.
Yeah.
As Bam, we mention you all the time.
It's a great way to get started. Already we've got celebrities who have noticed the show and who want to come on here. And which is great. I mean, we're getting
recognition.
Yes, I need my English skills again.
Oh, by the way, let me turn on the back light again. I knew there was something missing.
That'd be different, but, okay, let's just get off the light, okay? Let's end the show, okay. As you notice, I'm much more obnoxious than our first show, which was 6 months ago. Oh, boy. 6 months of this hell.
6 months. And tell about our show coming up. About, reminiscing.
Yeah, that's right. Our 15th show is a comedy hour, The Look Back. We're going to just...
Good look back.
Yes, we're going to look back at what we've done. We're going to talk about the good things and bad things. People who have come and go. And stuff like that.
People
and,
have come and gone, Mike.
Yeah, gone, yeah. People who have come and been fired. People we've had sex with and then gotten rid of. But,
People what? Never mind that.
I'd rather not talk about it. Even people who were actually supposed to be part of the show and never came on the show.
That's true.
15 shows is a lot for public access.
Yeah.
And we also have some big announcements we wanted to make. Coming next year, a year from now, a little less than a year from now, our California trip.
The California trip.
We're we're looking forward to this.
Yeah.
I'm paying for all of us. Only the cast members who really can go. I don't want any cast members who are part of this, because we're going to get new members. And we'll talk about that in a second. But all members who are part of this and want to be part, but we can't take extra people.
I think the original cast will go.
Yes. Basically, what you see here is mostly our cast. Chris Burke, Mike Burke, John Landolfi, and Lawrence Degan.
Not for long, now everyone's going to be coming just to go on the trip.
I don't want, all these people go just to come. We're going to California. We're going to probably spend 2 to 3 weeks there. I may even spend a month because either before or after my senior day, I'm moving there on my own. And I'm going to begin my career of acting. And my comedy career. And if things go well, we're going to get a network show, and we're going to work on this really hard. And then you could see us, we're all the way up here on Channel 32.
Yeah.
Or, if 32 doesn't air us, maybe on 08. I'm highly thinking about going there. I mentioned his name because I think he would like his name to be on TV. He said, your show's not going to make it. He said, get an original idea. Our show's making it. Brian Kennedy, here we are. Kennedy, of course. here you are. He comes at lunch a lot, and he once looked like the Cabbage Patch Kid when he got poison ivy, get all poofy and stuff.
Wait, I think I know who you're talking about.
Yeah. Yeah, he's got glasses in there.
I know.
Yeah.
Have you ever seen a talk show quite like this?
Yeah.
I don't think so. Though. People that run their own equipment, we do crazy things that nobody's ever done before.
He managed to have a show with
Has Oprah
life.
Ever done anything like this, Brian Kennedy?
Yeah.
Has Phil Donahue ever done anything like this?
And they're
opening the door to the new generation
of
talk shows.
And no offense to Dennis Miller. I love the guy.
Yeah.
Hey, I'm not gay. I'm a big fan of him. He's cool. He's great. You know, he's funny. But our show made it. And sorry to say he didn't, but we've been filming the show almost the same amount of time he has, but my life. Get a life. Well, there's some
everyone. Dear comedy team, what are you? Get a life, you stupid. Your show, no budget, it shows. Get a life. Get off TV, you.
Bye. That was our hate letter. Here's some of our good letters.
Yeah, good letters.
This year's from a celebrity. I don't want to mention their names because I don't know if they want to have it, but... Dear Mike Burke, I've seen your show. I live in Connecticut. I have my own talk show. There's a clue. I think you have a great show. You're going to make it. And when you want to be a guest on my show, and I'll be a guest on your show, let me know. You have a great show. Your comedy team is fantastic. You're all going to be stars. That's some good. Another one here. Dear Mike, I love you. I want you to go out with me. Please, marry me. I got about five letters like that. John got some love letters too. Lawrence, letter here. Dear Lawrence, you're the cutest guy I've ever seen.
Yeah.
Please. I can't believe this.
Lawrence.
Sign Miriam.
Lawrence, I think silent men are really sexy. That's what it said right here. Okay, I want to read one.
Let's start. John.
John, you hunk of burning love. I want to be your red hot love potato. Dear comedy team, you show. I watch it every week and even tape it, and I show it to all my friends. You're an inspiration to us all.
Signed, Elvis Presley.
I am alive.
Yeah.
Here, Lawrence, you can read one.
Okay.
Okay. Dear comedy team, I really enjoy all your shows, and I think they're pretty intelligent.
But...
Hey, a viewer spent a long time writing this letter, so don't laugh at him,
okay?
Most of all, I really like Lawrence Dagley. I think he's one of the cutest people ever, and definitely makes the rest of your cast look like dogs.
Signed, Robert Liston.
It's from a female fan in Hartford, Connecticut.
Her name is Sheila...
What's that? Sheila... I can't pronounce her last name.
Sheila Malamar.
That's what it is. Sheila
Malamar, something
like that. This one's for me. Let me read it. Dear John Landolfi, oh, you sex babe. Are you into bondage?
Oh, boy.
Come over to my house Friday night, and I will hit you with pain. You won't regret it. You won't.
Regret it, yes.
You won't.
Oh,
I'm salivating now. Oh, boy.
Read that love letter written by me. This was,
written by you?
No, written to me, actually. By, you know, name is...
Mike Burke. Yeah. Hi, it's me, Suzanne Vega. I wrote that song Luca for you. I was really thinking about you, but I couldn't say your name because I was too shocked.
I live on the second floor.
She was talking about you, Mike, obviously.
Yeah. Remember Tom's Diner? I wish there's a man, he's at the window, he's got his balls at the floor. There's a lady at the bar, she is sucking on some Malamar.
Oh my god.
Oh, look at this one.
Okay, here's one for me. Dear John, it's me, Madonna. I want you to star in my next movie. Justify My Love too. You could be the pimp. I'll be the prostitute. Wow.
Let's just
see some.
White Flesh.
Yeah!
Yes. Okay, so ladies and gentlemen, here's White Flesh.
Oh,
Oh,
no.
The Golden Girl.
Thank you for being a friend.
That's right, the guys on the comedy team will dress up like me. The Golden Girls, coming up next on the Comedy Hour. That will be followed by Weekend News.
Thank you for being a friend. The Golden Girls. And now?
Jesus, Mom, move. You move like molasses. Oh, my aching butt. I've been sitting on that train all day. I should have never taken you out of Shady Pine. Even though the place did catch on fire,
we
should have left you there.
Okay, okay.
Shady Pine, Mom.
I raised you.
Yeah, so did my cheap husband's family. He was such a pimp. What a loser. I'm so glad I could work.
I do.
Oh, what a night.
What'd you do to your hair?
Jesus, what's this do?
What?
Blanche, Jesus Christ, you stubborn
whore. What'd you do? Get out. With your head stuck in the toilet?
Jesus.
Oh, hi, girl.
Rose, what are you doing here, Rose?
Rose, how did things go with the man last night?
You were there.
No.
Oh.
Jesus, Rose, you're so stupid. And you
live. Where'd you get
out of here? Guys, you know what this reminds me of, all of us sitting here?
That dress is so
I remember.
Let's have cheesecake.
Girls, you know what this reminds me of? Back in St. Olaf, when John Flurkenflacken came,
Jesus, there was another one that rose a 20-hour story.
And he made some Flurkenflacken pie.
Rose, shut up with the St. Olaf stories. We've heard them all.
And close your legs. You look like
close your legs. You're taking after Blanche. Close your legs. Look at this. Blanche, I'm sick and tired of these sex toys in my room. Look at this. A harness.
Look at
a dead harness for sexual action.
Hey, girl.
Look, whip. There is whip in my room.
I'm so sorry.
Hey, girl, what would you say? What did you say?
Look at your legs. They're hairy. They look like... Have you shaved what?
Ma, you shaved your mustache with my legs. Now look at my legs. They're so hairy. Look at this. Pluck, pluck. Jesus,
my... Girls, I just got an idea.
I have to wear pants underneath my lovely skirt.
Legs, dear.
Rose, shut up.
But Dorothy, I just got a plan. What if we buy a pig?
Is this another one of your puns?
No, Rose. I remember in St. Olaf when we had a pig.
Shut up, Rose.
He ran for town president. Wilbur the pig, he went for town president.
Then I shot him and ate him.
Shady Pines, Ma.
Now, this, how was your night?
Oh, it was full of ecstasy. Why, when Tom grabbed my penny bosom.
There was nothing there.
Shut up, Ma, Shady Pines.
Oh, how was it, Blanche?
Oh, it was excellent.
Oh, we don't want to hear about your bosom, Blanche. Let me tell you about something. I haven't had a man in 50 years. Ever since my disgusting. Hey, husband.
Hey, Dorothy, it's Stan.
Jesus, oh, get him out of here, then.
Dorothy, let me in.
Oh, I'll just be right back.
Stop it.
Oh,
don't
Stan.
Get him. Please don't leave ball.
Stan, get him out with her. Hey, Stan, can I tell you about my St. Olaf story?
Oh, I'm getting out of here.
Thank you, Rose, for getting rid of him like you did. I'm so glad you're my friend.
Well, girls, I gotta go.
Thank you for being a friend.
I'm going to see Harry Weston. He got one of those pups, a little schnauzer dog.
You're not getting a puppy. You look like a schnauzer dog.
Blanche, I have to ask
you a question. Why do we need a dog when you look like a dog?
Shady Pines, Mom. Blanche, I have to ask you a question. How do you keep your breath so high? Look at these breaths. They just flop right back down. How can I get them first?
Look at mine.
Some people just naturally beautiful looking breasts like myself.
Hey, girl!
You had nothing yet. Look how flat it is.
Shady Pine, Ma, shut up.
Hey, girls, what do you say I got this puppet?
You need glasses. You need a facelift, Ma.
I'll send you to Shady Pine.
I'll send you to Shady Pine. However, we should burn down the two in it.
What is with this green makeup all over your face?
Green makeup.
You look
it's the newest shade. It's the newest shade, Ma. Jesus.
Hey, what's so wrong about it?
Jesus, I don't want an animal.
Quick, let me get the gun. I want around here in the van.
I'm too old to be doing things like this with chasing pigs around.
Dorothy, we're speaking tomorrow morning. Dorothy, where's the president?
In Idaho, Rose. Is there anybody home? Hello? I think you left your brain in St. Olaf, Rose.
Fine, if you want to be that way.
I do want to be that way.
Get that smell of pig out of there.
I don't want to chase around after a pig.
The only thing I want around here is a man.
Shut up, you poor.
You look like a man.
Oh, girl. Say it fine, Sophia.
Hey, thank you. Bye.
I should have put you up for adoption.
Sophia! That was for you!
Well, who was it?
Say that you have to go. It's Harry. Who's Harry?
Oh, come on, spit it out.
Hey, just like your butt, Harry.
Tell us the gossip, Mom. We want to know about all the men in your life.
You have to go. He's in the hospital.
Harry's just the man I met.
Sophia, he's in the hospital.
Run, Mom. Run. Go. Look at my hair, so dry and brittle.
Did you see that?
Something about perspiration dripping down my bosom that makes me so
You are horny. I hate being in this little place, being that a house got ripped apart from hurricane.
That's exactly right.
Where is the hurricane?
In Zimbabwe, Rose. Jesus!
Zimbabwe? Is that a name of a person?
Jesus, my throat gets sore. I have to yell 24 hours a day. Let's dig out.
Hey, it's a
cheesecake.
Hey, Sophia.
Hey, guys.
My hemorrhoids are killing me.
Chris, what do you say? Isn't Blanche the town slut?
I would think so.
Well, let me tell you another St. Olaf story.
Oh, you dumb airhead.
Oh, Doc, isn't she a slut?
No, she's not a slut.
I don't need to take this kind of abuse, you know. There's a man out there waiting for me.
Well, Sophia's face looks like a cartoon.
Looks like there's ants crawling through
her face. Well, look at all that green on your face.
It's the newest shade. Shady Pine Farm.
Stay on, Sophia.
Mom, the Miami heat. I'm used to living in New York, being a tough New York
state. I have a lot of heat.
Oh, I have you every night.
Where? In the gas stove, Blanche? Rose, I can't even tell who you are anymore.
Straighten your bosoms. They're crooked.
Look at this, Mom. Look. My bosoms are hitting the floor.
Anybody want to look at my bosoms?
Close your legs. Close them.
Right, look at this. I'm you. I had to pop all these kids out. No good kids.
Come on, girls. Let's stand up. Let's see who's taller.
I think I am.
Let's get my bosoms.
Thank you for being a friend.
Look at that, listen.
Don't do that. My butt is still killing from that.
We ought to go.
Hey, let's do a can-can, girl. Okay, ready? I think my bosom fell off.
Everyone, let's work.
Are you okay, Mom?
Sophia, are you okay?
Ma! Oh, thank God she's dead. Now we need insurance money.
Oh,
my God. Rose is half past.
Get off me, you dumb airhead.
Ma was rescued.
Oh, no.
I'm your reporter for the evening, John Landolfi. And later on, we're going to be having Mike Burke live at the Republican convention. He's going to be talking about that. But every time I'm the reporter, someone's running in front of the cameras, back and forth, back and forth. Okay, this is what I've seen at the Republican convention. Bush had a pretty good... I quit. Mrs. Butterworth can take my job.
I'm Mrs. Butterworth.
She can report.
I'm nasty, tasty, real sticky. So run me over your body when you do it.
Okay, Bush had a good speech, and it ran 1 minute over Clinton, which was incredibly long. And, so Bush is going to have a book coming out, actually a whole series of encyclopedia-sized books, that will be his speech. And, but one thing that, I told me was Ronald Reagan, it always seems like a nice guy, and he had, I heard, he was pretty mean in his speech. I heard it was a pretty good speech, but he was mean, and, you know, he was talking about that Michael Jackson should run with George Bush. And I don't understand that, but when I asked him, he said, because Michael Jackson's a good speller. So, I don't know. And George Buchanan, I don't know. What's his name, Pat Buchanan?
Yeah.
Yeah, George. Well, Pat Buchanan, he's mean too, so I don't know. But I'm going to Mike now, because I don't know what I'm talking about. Because I'm a Democrat. No, I'm just kidding. Okay, let's go to Mike. Mike?
Whoa. Simon here at Weekend News. Normally me and John anchor the news, but I'm not here. Now, John, as I can see you now, you are angry, aren't you? Well, John, what do you think of Mr. Bush's speech?
Thank you. It was pretty good, actually, Mike, and I thought it was really, really long.
Yeah, like I heard it ran like 1 minute over Clinton's. It was interesting, though. I mean, Clinton now is just... my mother, my father, my kids, you know.
I like Barbara's speech.
Yes, yes,
Barbara
she
has
a good
speech. Yeah. Have you seen Barbara Bush, Mike?
Yeah.
Did you get her autograph for me?
As a matter of fact, I did. I saw Barbara Bush, and, you know, as you could say, I have to dress like this. I got the tie on and everything because... well, I'm in Houston here. And, well, it's been pretty cool here because, I mean, you see, I saw Ronald Reagan do a speech, George Bush, I mean, to see the actual president right there, it was something. Right now, I'm under the stadium because it is just, it's too noisy up there and I got a headache, you know, from being there all week. So I decided to come down here where it's much quieter. And plus, this is backstage where the president and everyone else comes through. It comes through these doors. Now, of all things, I couldn't believe it when I saw that the bottom doors were just like ours in our studio. You know, it's kind of odd. Of course, we always film in the day and it's nighttime here. But, you know, it's pretty good here. Now, Lawrence Degley also came along. He didn't dress for the occasion. But, we're going to be going to him in a moment. And he'll be with George Bush first.
Mike,
yes.
I have a question. During the big point in George Bush's speech, did the balloons come down?
Yes, actually,
did you get a few souvenirs?
Yeah, I took, there was like these balloons when his speech ended. They were like the size of Barbara Bush, actually. No offense, Barbara. I'm sorry, she's back there. Actually, it's the size of the way Roseanne used to be. These things were like, they were huge. I mean, yeah, you could see Barbara Bush going, pointing at them, they were so big, but, as you know, I'm very...
That's
very
incredible, Mike. What other speeches did you like?
Pat Buchanan had a pretty good speech, except he seemed to kind of like he hated everyone. He made fun of poor people and rich people, everyone, from every side, and anything that had to do with the Democrats or anything. He had a pretty good speech, though.
Is that true about what Ronald Reagan said about Michael Jackson running for vice?
Oh, wait a minute, a little microphone. Did you say anything?
Is it true what Ronald Reagan said about Michael Jackson running for the vice president?
Yeah, there has been some talk of that. Ronald Reagan came up to me, actually, and was telling me about how he thought Michael Jackson could... You know, because he spells better and he dances so he'd get things done faster than Quail. And Ronald Reagan said he could moonwalk right across the stage. And, I think I heard someone say he was here. But I'm not too sure about that. Any more questions?
Yeah, do you spell potato?
Actually, logically, I can't, because I'm retarded and, it's P-O-T-O-E, am I right?
No, sorry. I think
wow, she's looking mad and tasty tonight. I can taste her now.
Well, when you get back, Mike, we're going to make some pancakes up and, Miss Butter will host the evening.
I just want to get this friggin' tie off. okay, John, let's get Lawrence Degley now. Lawrence, where are you, man? Are you out there? Whoa, we just left a bunch of bugs in here.
There I am.
Hey, there you are, Mr. Degley.
Yeah. How are you?
They got these cheap spotlights here for the president. Now, I've got to go because I knew about maybe interviewing me. Look, my face is all red. See, here in Houston, we filmed a skit, and Lawrence and I put makeup on.
Yeah.
So, you're going to be talking to Ronald Reagan and George Bush. I think George Bush is first, so when he comes out here, deal with it. You can talk to John for a while. John, back to you.
Hey,
yeah.
John. What's
yeah.
up?
Lawrence, how is it down there in Houston?
Oh, it's nice.
Is there any exciting points in the Republican convention that you want to bring out to the viewing audience?
Well, I haven't really been paying attention. I just basically came down here with Mike. You went to the convention, and I just basically stayed at the hotel. But I'm really excited about meeting George Bush, but hope he doesn't puke like he did the time you interviewed him.
That is true. Mr. Bush is a real puker. I'll tell you, watch out, wear a raincoat when you're around him.
Okay.
That's my advice for you. What do you think about Barbara?
Oh, she's nice. I ran into her before.
Did she have Millie with her?
Yeah, they were taking
White House dog.
Yeah, they were taking him for a walk.
I heard it's true that they kind of look alike, actually.
Well, yeah, if you look at it in a certain way.
There is talk that's her daughter, really. Her mutant daughter.
Mm-hmm. I haven't asked her about that.
You heard the rumors about Bush, you know, George, the whole family. Little topsy-turvy, incestuous little menage a trois thing. So what do you think about that?
I don't know. What do you think about it?
I really think Mr. Bush is a pervert. So
do you?
No.
I really don't know. He seems committed to Barbara, but who knows?
That's true. Well,
what did you do with the glasses?
Okay, so, what do you think about Ronald Reagan? Does he still look like the Crypt Keeper, actually? From the Tales from the Crypt series on HBO?
Yeah, but he's still
hilarious, actually.
Yeah, but...
Stand up straight, Lawrence.
How is this? Is this straight enough?
Is that straight enough, cameraman? We're by a satellite, so I have no idea what the cameraman is doing.
Okay.
We're having some difficulties, Lawrence, so you're going to have to stand straight, right in the light, looking directly into the camera.
All right, how's that?
That's good.
All right.
So, what do you think about our Ronald, really? What do you think about his speech and everything?
I thought he gave a really good speech, and it just shows that how much our country got screwed up after he left.
George Bush is there now?
Yeah, he just got here.
Ready? Talk, keep talking, then I'll...
Oh, let's start the interview with him.
Oh, hi.
George.
Sorry, there's all those people out, man.
Mr. Bush, it's really a pleasure to meet you. Hello.
How you doing?
Hi, Mr. Good. Bush.
Hi, you're...
That's our anchor person back from Connecticut.
Where's that voice coming from?
It's me, John Landolfi, back here in the North Branford, Connecticut.
Coming via
satellite.
John Landolfi, the guy I puked on. But how you doing?
I'm okay, and I just wanted to let you know, I gave some pointers to Lawrence. I told him to wear a raincoat when around you.
Well, that's good advice.
We hope you feel better tonight.
It's kind of like, I'm fine. Okay, that speech I just had was good.
Okay. Good.
It's great to meet you, Lawrence.
Thank you.
I told him that I was supposed to talk to you. I talked to Mike Burke a few seconds ago.
Oh, really? Is he out there?
Yes, he's over there somewhere.
He would have liked to have met you too, but I guess...
Well, we've met.
Yeah.
I guess he's a bit more people would like to see them both on the screen, us and him. Him and them, Barbara and...
There's an incredible similarity between the two of you, when you think about it.
Well, maybe. Maybe in the voice. He does me better than I do me.
Now. Dallas.
now. That's
news.
There's 1,000 points of light. And each point of light was in that auditorium, that Astrodome, up any little thing, 1,000. Well, it wouldn't be prudent if each light was not to be considered. Now, let me tell you about my economy plan. The economy plan is good. I think we should take 10% out of each tax cut, and then we get money from paying the deficit. It'll be great.
Okay. I wanted to ask you if there was any truth to the rumor that you've been fooling around, you know?
I don't blame you!
Mr. Bagley.
We don't... camera guy.
Well, I'm a little shocked that you asked me that question, Mr. Bagley. No, I'm not having an affair.
Okay.
I am not! Man, Barbara, straight!
I heard there were so many rumors, I just had to make sure. I'm sorry. How's Millie?
Well, Millie is doing pretty good.
Did you have a sauce yet for the...
Actually, yes, but we're trying to mate her so we can get a little more Millie's. A little tiny one. Good little...
Okay, John, you got anything to ask Mr. Bush?
Yeah,
I can't hear them at all, though. He's, chubby. Why are they giving this microphone?
Yeah. Okay.
Looks like I have a hearing aid. Hello?
Yes, Mr. Bush, how are you doing tonight?
Well, voice is a little sore after doing that hour and a half speech. Actually, it was an hour, a little less, but it was a long speech. And I wanted to get my points across. My voice is a little good, a little sore, but I'm doing pretty good.
I have a question, Mr. Bush. Did you, those balloons that came down, did you and Barbara blow them up yourself?
actually... Barbara did. Now I just want to tell the truth here. This good committee at the Astrodome, the people, the supporters of me, supporters, they blew them up by helium, I think it was. No, it could have been helium. Compressed air.
That's incredible, Mr. President.
Isn't there a television show called That's Incredible?
That is. No, there is actually.
Yes.
I heard you were on that show once, Mr. President, and you were actually, walking on the broken glass and, eating light bulbs, I believe.
That's right. I swallowed a light bulb whole and sucked it back up. John, I hate to cut you off, but I gotta go. As you can see, his time, man.
Yep.
Ronald Reagan's coming next.
Wow.
So, thank you, and, God bless you. Bye, Mr. Bagley.
Bye, John.
Thank you very much.
Mr. President, wait 1 second. I just want to congratulate you on holding an interview without vomiting. That was so professional. Outside, please.
Yes, Ken. Goodbye.
Bye.
Mr. President, Mr. President, no questions.
That was
an incredible interview, Lawrence. Don't you think so?
Yes, I did.
I thought the... What do you think about Mrs. Butterworth's character?
I think it brings an exciting addition to this show that really... Mr. Reagan!
Here's Mr. Reagan! Yeah.
Hello, how are you? This is really a great time I had tonight. I met the President of the United States and the former President.
Where's the bathroom?
It's down the hall.
Oh, wait a minute. Oh, that was earlier.
You're here to do an interview with me. I'm Lawrence Stegley.
Lawrence
Stegley, that's me.
Lawrence Stegley?
Yes, that's me.
Hello, Lawrence.
Hi.
How are you?
Well, I'm doing pretty good. You know, you sort of look like Thomas Jefferson. You know, I knew Thomas Jefferson, and you are new Thomas Jefferson.
Thank you, sir. Our anchorman back in Connecticut asked me to ask you,
how
do you keep yourself looking so youthful?
Where's Connecticut?
Oh, it's one of those states up there. How do you keep yourself looking so youthful?
Well, I remain stiff, as you can see. I exercise, and I don't have plastic surgery like the other actors. Yes.
How does your wife keep herself looking so beautiful?
Wife?
Nancy?
Oh, the phone operator? Hi, this is Nancy.
Oh, no. Your wife.
Yes, my wife.
Yeah.
We do it every night. We exercise together, and, well, she dresses pretty well.
Yeah, speaking of her dresses, where does she get her dresses, by the way?
Calvin Klein.
Okay.
Well, that's it.
Okay, John?
I was just wondering, is it true, Mr. Reagan, that that's what put us in the deficit, is all those dresses that your wife bought?
Well, that's what they said, but I didn't believe them.
You look confused, Mr. Reagan. Is there something...
I'm older than you. I'm older than you. I'm older than Mike put together. Well, I'm the oldest man in America. Well, this is George Burns, above whom...
I have one question. I heard you were in a relation to the Crypt Keeper from the HBO series Tales from the Crypt. I heard you were his long-lost brother.
Well,
I can see the resemblance, frankly.
Yeah.
Well, actually, yes. He's my long-lost brother, Kip. Kip Reagan. That's why they call me the Kipper. Oh, wait a minute, that's the Kipper. Oh.
Okay. What else should I ask him, John? Anything else?
Yes. To ask a question, you must do it with dignity. If you don't have dignity, You can't ask the question.
Okay.
Because when you can't ask the question, you can't, talk like an amigo.
Okay.
Well, Saddam Hussein, Bush, what a good man he is, Bush, but he likes to call him Sam. I want to say Bush, he's not a horse saddle, but a saddle.
Okay. Mr. Reagan.
Yes.
I was just wondering, why when you speak does your head shake like a baseball bat?
Well, that's because I'm old. And well, if you jerk it, it keeps you standing still.
You do jerk?
Well, every night when I talk and...
Mr. Reagan, that's disgusting.
Oh, I see what you mean. Yes.
Have you ever vomited like George Bush, actually, in your career?
Well, that's one of my secrets to staying alive. I don't fart, I don't puke.
Okay, well, I'm sure you're really busy, and I want to thank you for taking the time.
I'm not busy. But by the way, where's the White House? I'm the president, I've got to go there.
No, you're not the president anymore, I'm sorry.
Well, then I guess I'm not busy.
Where do you live now, Mr. Reagan? I heard on a ranch somewhere.
Yes, I live, I have a ranch in Texas, but in Northern California, I like to live there. And, well, I've lived in Sacramento a few times, and on Pluto, the planet, a couple of times.
That's incredible.
Yes.
Do you have any talents that you'd like to do right now?
Well, I can dance like Michael Jackson.
Oh, I'd love to see that, Mr. Ed.
Do me, baby.
That was very good.
That was very good, Mr. Reagan.
You're multi-talented.
Do you do parties?
Well, yes. I need a job. You got two questions, and I have to leave. You have two questions.
Okay. I don't know. So how are you keeping yourself busy these days, anyway?
Well, I can't recall. I'm having chest pains.
Yes, is it true, the rumor about Barbara Bush being the actual Mrs. Fletcher in the life call?
Well,
the commercial?
Yes, when she was younger and thinner, I was her. I've fallen, and I can't get up. Ooh, my knees. One more question.
Okay, the last question. If you could have served more terms than, like, if there wasn't a law that you can only serve two terms, would you keep going until forever? Or do you think it was time to hang up the... anyway.
Well, I'd hang up a wiener, put it on a rack, or wrap it around a walker, but yes, I would keep on going. If I could be president tomorrow, I would.
I think that you'd really still be a very good president because you moved everybody with that speech you made the other day. It's incredible. It's better than Bush's speech, and he's the current president.
Well, thank you. By the way, I knew Thomas Jefferson, and Clinton, you are no Thomas Jefferson. And I knew Dan Quayle, Will. No one is Dan Quayle.
Mr. Reagan.
Yes.
Are those bugle boy jeans you're wearing?
Who? Well, yes, they are. Why do you ask?
I was just wondering where I could get a pair, frankly.
Macy's. When they go out of business, I got them cheap. Okay.
Okay. Thank you very much.
God bless you. God bless you, John. And God bless America.
Well, thank you, Mr. Reagan.
God bless America.
Thank you very much for coming.
It was really a really big pleasure to meet you. Doors.
Be careful, Mr. Reagan.
There you go. All right. I guess we'll go back to the studio now. So that's all we have here.
For incredible interviews, and I thank you very much, Lawrence. You're an excellent reporter. Here goes the people running in front of the cameras again. I think that's my trademark for the evening. The interviews were wonderful, actually. I learned so much from George Bush and Ronald Reagan. I learned that to make it, you don't vomit, and you don't pass gas. That is one of the secrets, and I learned that Nancy Reagan actually did put us in a deficit. I find that hard to believe, and you heard it here first. That's the Always Stand on Weekend News. That's our motto now, actually. So, I think that's it for the evening. I hope you liked the interviews, and we'll be doing more interviews with the president and other things as the election goes on. So, for the Weekend News, on behalf of Mike, I'm John Landolfi. Good night.
Well, that was rather interesting Weekend News. That was live. What we're talking about now, this is all on tape. What we had before was all live. Lawrence, we went out there. I don't know what happened, but because what we saw was actually live on television. But this is the end of our show. Next show is our 14th show. Then after that, I want you to watch because it's our special edition, the Comedy Hour, A Look Back. And we'll look back at work. Bye-bye.
Ready?
I thought you weren't going to say bye-bye no more. Bye-bye.
Did I say bye-bye?
Yeah.
No.
Okay.
I didn't realize it.
Yeah, ready? Are you serious? That's going to be a last show?
Bye-bye.